Jamelia has a greenhouse that she uses to grow fruit and vegetables. She needs to make sure the temperature in the greenhouse stays between 25 degrees Celsius and 30 degrees Celsius, inclusive. A system that has a temperature sensor and a microprocessor is used to maintain the temperature in the greenhouse. The system will open a window and turn a heater off if it gets too cold, open a window and turn a heater off if it gets too hot, close a window and turn a heater on if it gets too cold. Describe how the system uses the temperature sensor and the microprocessor to maintain the temperature in the greenhouse. This question is for 8 marks, and at first glance may seem like quite a difficult question to answer. However, there is a 4-step process we can follow that we can use to answer any type of question to do with these sorts of systems. We'll go through that process in a bit. Let's first understand what the question is asking and try to visualize the system in a diagram. We've been told that there is a greenhouse where we are growing fruit and vegetables. We want to ensure the temperature stays between 25 degrees and 30 degrees Celsius. We have a system in place that does that using a temperature sensor. This temperature sensor will send the current temperature to the microprocessor. If it is below 25 degrees, it will close a window and turn the heater on. If it is above 30 degrees, it will open a window and turn the heater off. Let's draw the system as a diagram. Initially, we have a temperature sensor that is going to measure the current temperature of the greenhouse. Temperature is what's known as analog data. Analog data is data that is stored as physical signals. Examples could be sound, light, heat, or even alkalinity. Computers cannot understand analog data, as computers use electronic signals, stored as binary. This data is known as digital data. For a computer or a microprocessor to be able to work with temperature, we need to convert it from analog into a digital form. For this, we use what's called an analog to digital converter. ADCs come in many different forms, since there are many types of analog data. You wouldn't convert temperature into digital the same way that you'd convert sound into digital data. Once we have this data as a digital form, we now send it to the microprocessor. A microprocessor is a more compact, less powerful version of a CPU. It is used in these systems as it does not require as much power as a CPU and can be made to do specific tasks. The purpose of the microprocessor in the system is to compare the value from the temperature sensor to the stored values of 25 degrees Celsius and 30 degrees Celsius. The process now splits into 3 different sections. If the value of the temperature sensor is between 25 degrees and 30 degrees inclusive, nothing is going to happen. If the temperature is greater than 30 degrees, it will send a signal to an actuator on a window that will open the window and will send a signal to the heater to turn it off. If the temperature value is less than 25 degrees, it will send a signal to the actuator on the window to close the window, and then send a signal to the heater to turn it on. This entire system is a continuous system. In other words, it repeats the process and does so until the microprocessor is turned off. Now let's go through the 4-step process we can follow to answer the question. Step 1 is to mention that the sensor measures data, it converts the data to digital using an ADC, and sends the data to a microprocessor. The second step is to do a comparison between the stored values that we've been given. The microprocessor performs this comparison. The next step is to describe the actions that happen as a result of the comparison. And the last step is to mention that the process is a continuous process. In other words, it repeats. One way you could remember this process is with the acronym SCAR. Let's go ahead and now write out the answer to the question, bearing in mind that we need to make 8 distinct points using these 4 steps. First off, the sensor sends data to a microprocessor, and data is converted using an ADC. That is our first step complete. Step 2 and step 3 can be done together. Here we are saying the microprocessor compares data to stored values. If the temperature is greater than 30, what is the action that's going to occur? We can say that a signal is sent to open the window and to turn the heater off. Next, we want to mention what happens if the temperature is less than 25 degrees. A signal is sent to an actuator to close the window and turn the heater on. Lastly, we want to mention this third point, which is if it's between 25 degrees and 30 degrees, no action is taken. That is the second and third step complete. The fourth step is to now mention that this process is a continuous process. In other words, it repeats. The whole process is continuous. And there we go, that is this question completed.